I put my globe on America, but it's such a small globe that I don't think anyone saw it. So like North America, South America, it's a stupid globe. I need a new one that's bigger. We've all suspected that humans arrived in the Americas much earlier than was long thought by the researchers and historians. The ancient footprints that are scattered along the dried-up lakebed of Lake Otero in White Sands, New Mexico, have been confirmed by scientists to have been dated as the earliest known footprints in North America. This conformation pushes back the timeline of humans arriving in North America that was believed to have happened around 13,000 years ago by at least 10,000 years, to the humans arriving by at least 23,000 years ago. Some footprints found here might even be 30,000 years old, which would push back the timeline by at least 20,000 years, although this is not yet confirmed. My name is Kaylee, and let's take a look into this latest archaeological discovery that will absolutely rewrite the history books. For a long time, there was a really big lake in New Mexico called Lake Otero. Back then, the climate was more wet and the area around the lake had a lot of vegetation, grasslands stretching for miles. This lush green area became the primary hunting grounds for fearsome predators like dire wolves and the American lion. They preyed on the plant eaters that grazed in the area of the Tularosa Basin. When the last ice age ended around 12,000 years ago, the lake started to evaporate. Rain and snowmelt carried dissolved gypsum from the mountain ranges surrounding the lake into the basin. The question one can ask is, how long have humans been living in the Tularosa Basin? And this latest discovered conformation shows that humans have been inhabiting the area during the Ice Age's megafauna for a lot longer than we previously thought. For a long time, ghostly footprints would appear on the wet ground at White Sands, New Mexico, only for these prints to disappear once the ground dried out. For approximately 80 years, there was a small collection of fossilized footprints known to researchers, but a group of scientists discovered the dark spots along the dried-up lakebed that appeared to be footprints. Scientists wouldn't be scientists if curiosity didn't get the better of them, so they decided to dig up these strange dark spots, better known as the ghostly footprints. This eventually led to the discovery of the paleo-human footprints and the Harlan's ground sloth. They also discovered footprints of a dire wolf with ancient seeds next to it. These seeds were dated to have been 18,000 years old. To research these ghost prints, a trench was dug into the brown gypsum soil. This is where there were footprints found below the surface at different depths. Above and below these footprints, the researchers discovered ancient grass seeds from a species of grass called Rupia cirrhosa, but more commonly known as ditch grass. The researchers then had these seeds analyzed using radiocarbon dating to figure out their age and the age of the footprints found near the seeds. The results of the radiocarbon dating calibrated dates between 22,860 and 21,130 years ago. This showed that these are the oldest known discovered footprints in North America. This study went a bit further. According to the research in the journal Science, based on the walking speed and stature, it appeared that most of these footprints were from teenagers and children. This led to a hypothesis for a division of labor, where the adults would perform the skilled tasks, like for instance, hunting, and the teenagers and children would mostly do tasks like fetching and carrying things. The gathering parts of the hunter-gatherer lifestyle seemed to have been carried out by the teenagers, with the children accompanying them. The children left most of the footprints in this area. This is a pattern commonly found in all excavated surfaces and depths at the Tularosa Basin. At White Sands, there are many remarkable tracks found scattered along the dried-out lakebed. Some of these tracks extend for long distances, and many of the footprints discovered here have found to have coexisted and interacted with the extinct Ice Age animals. In 2018, researchers discovered the footprints that they believe to have belonged to a female. These prints tell a story that is familiar to this day. Her footprints show her walking, but occasionally toddler footprints show up besides hers. The footprints of the female slipped in the mud and broadened at times, most likely from the additional weight of carrying the young child and changing the position in which she held the child. The last ice age ended, like I've discussed in my Doggerland video. This changed the Earth's climate, the onset and subsequent ending of the Younger Dryas, and the Earth became warmer and the rising of global sea levels. The once lush green grasslands with an abundance of vegetation began to disappear, and with it, the great beasts of the Ice Age disappeared as well. These fossilized footprints at White Sands are currently the most important resources in the Americas when it comes to the understanding of the interactions between the humans and the extinct animals who coexisted there during the Ice Age. Fossilized footprints of animals living at White Sands more than 10,000 years ago are scattered along the dried-up lakebed, trackways and trample grounds from ancient camels and Colombian mammoths, for instance. The inhabitants of the Tularosa Basin during the Ice Age left very little to almost no proof of their existence. Some pieces of stone flakes from tool making, arrowheads and spear points have been found throughout the basin. Although it seems that almost all of these belong to inhabitants who lived there after the Ice Age had ended. This is in contrast with the surrounding areas that are filled with items left behind from ancient inhabitants. The dried up lakebed of Lake Otero seems to be almost devoid of artifacts that date from before the Spanish explorations in the 1500s. Therefore, there's almost nothing left from the Ice Age as well, besides these fossilized footprints of animals and humans. These footprints, among other features found in the landscape, have further propelled the movement to redesignate the White Sands National Monuments into the White Sands National Park. It's a massive landscape that is filled with history stretching from the Ice Age to modern times, proving that this area is more than just a dried out desert. To me, it shows that while we do think we know so much about the ancient world, we actually know very little, and we will keep making discoveries that will keep changing and rewriting the history books that we use today. But to me, that's also the beauty of history. It isn't stagnant, it's ever changing, and as time goes on, we will keep uncovering more things, and we will change and broaden our understanding of the ancient world. But with that said, you've reached the end of this video. If you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified every time I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, now that's a shame, click the card in the upper right corner. I've put links in the description down below, and I always put videos in my end card. I'd also like to thank my patrons: Barry Scott, Floyd Vaughn, Rox, Jamie Hernandez, Dan Fowler, Jeff Henderson, DJ, Klaus Jepsen, CivilPoliticsRadio.com, Ricky, Prabhu DC, Ira Whiteside, Malleus Flavus, Tom Barkwell, Jeff Rooks, Ben Serinus, Andreas Angurakis, Dibbler666, Wolfgang Senker, Jens Hotnell, Menno Bax, Nick, Hans van Poelgeest, James Lattimore, and NGC6543. I'd also like to thank my channel members: Naversky, Malleus Flavus, Henry Hewitt, Stephen Jenny, John Jiff, Barry, Erik van Dorp, The Giant, Milo Watlin, Harry Hans, Greg George, Mo Ter, Volps Volps, Tim Smith, Marua Olbegen, Ira Whiteside, James Fisher, George Kovacs, Joffre Cueva, Steven Salmon, Patrick, Marcus Lynch, and Ben Oppenheimer. And thank you all for watching. This wasn't the easiest video for me to film, but I'm back and I'm not going anywhere. So I'll see you in the next one. Bye. And I secretly poured my Malibu in a glass so that people wouldn't think that I drank alcohol today. Granted, I hadn't drank alcohol in 9 days. I deserve Malibu. I was covered in vegetation.